at 170,000 miles in diameter, but only 30 feet thick in places, Saturn's beautiful rings have always stolen the show. But their origin is still a mystery.
Saturn has these beautiful rings that really define it as a planet, but it's unique in the solar system in the sense that no other planet has such a big ring system.
All of the other gas giants have remnants of a ring, kind of small, thin, dark rings, but nothing like Saturn. So something very different happened around Saturn.
A clue comes from the ring's composition. They're around 99% water ice, giving the rings their sparkling appearance. This leads astronomers to a bold theory.
We do not know how Saturn's icy rings formed. We're not even sure how old they are. But one idea is that they formed from ice that was existing previously on a moon. How amazing is that?
Several billion years ago, Saturn may have been ringless, with a large, icy moon.
The moon was big enough that its gravity drew heavier stuff like rock to its core, and lighter stuff like ice floated to the top.
We think the moon strayed too close to Saturn.
The gravity from Saturn could tear it apart, and it could separate the ices from the rocky parts, and the ices could stay in orbit and form our rings, and the rocky parts would get swallowed up by Saturn.
The death of a large moon may have built the rings, but they owe their current appearance to the moons that are still alive.
When you go back to Saturn's rings time and time again, they're all slightly different. They are changing, they are braiding in and out of each other. We had no idea there would be so much beauty and so much mystery in the rings.
The behavior of two of Saturn's moons, Prometheus and Atlas, which are embedded in the rings, is especially surprising.
Some of these smallest moons are interspersed within the ring system. Some of them are doing something really bizarre.
In some cases, it looks like the moons were shepherding the edges of the rings and keeping them in their place.
The moon's gravity cleans up the rings, sometimes sculpting shapes in their wake.
Saturn's rings aren't static, and there's some really fascinating interactions where moons are clearly pushing on the rings and causing weird and cool waves, making the rings just that much more beautiful.
The whole dance between Saturn, its moons, its rings, how they all are interconnected is just completely fascinating.
It's a dynamic, amazing, living, geologically vibrant place.
Saturn's moons may keep the rings orderly, but they can't explain why the rings are so clean, almost pristine.
They're too shiny. If they were billions of years old, they should have collected a lot of dust by now and be a lot darker. The fact that they're shiny kind of implies that maybe they're a lot younger than we first thought.
Perhaps the rings we see today are a more recent upgrade.
The rings might only be 100 million years old, about the time of the dinosaurs.
So if the dinosaurs had invented telescopes, they could have seen Saturn without rings.
And it makes you wonder, is this the first ring system that Saturn had, or was there another ring system that maybe slowly eroded away? Perhaps a comet or a body came in too close to Saturn and Saturn's gravity literally tore it apart, and then we got a brand new ring system.
The later dinosaurs could have watched the rings form, and then they would have been wiped out by an asteroid. Yeah, should have built better telescopes, dinosaurs. Sucks to be you.
We still don't know why the rings of Saturn are so clean.
It could be that the rings really are old and they have some sort of cleaning system which removes the dust from them, making them look young. Or they may actually be young, then this may be the seventh or eighth or whatever generation rings.
It is so different than any other planetary system. And those mysteries still exist. We have some idea what went on, but there's a lot that we don't know about Saturn.
Midway through its 13-year mission to Saturn, Cassini captures an intriguing image. A bright feature at the edge of one of Saturn's outermost rings. Something we'd never seen before.
I was really excited when we saw these images of Saturn's rings, and it looked like there was a lump, maybe a moon forming there, which they nicknamed Peggy.
Named after the mother-in-law of the scientist who discovered it, Peggy was still too small to be considered a fully formed moon. But nearby orbits a group of objects that are just big enough to be moons. And they are really weird.
These moons are really unusual. We don't think of them as like anything else we've seen. They're kind of little fuzzy potatoes, or maybe even like a ravioli is another one, or a croissant. Why do we always come up with food? But at the same time, that's exactly what they look like. The most bizarrely shaped moon of Saturn is Pan. It's got these crisscrossing cracks just like bread. And then around the outside is a belly band. It's undulatory. How would this get there?
Cassini discovered a clue. Like Saturn's rings, these moons were made almost entirely of water ice. They must have grown from tiny lumps trapped within the rings.
They're going to be extremely fragile, kind of like a snowflake orbiting Saturn. They can start drawing in material and then can grow.
You can actually imagine rolling up a snowball and accumulating more and more particles on the outside. And in the same way, you could accumulate these clumps in the rings. And if they're near the edge of the rings, perhaps they actually break free and go out to form tiny moons.
The size of these space snowballs, tens of miles across or less, helps explain their unusual shapes.
The size of the moon actually affects its shape in that once you get below a certain size threshold, you cannot be round anymore. That's because the strength of the rock, or the ice in this case, is too great to be overcome by gravity, and so the kind of oblong shapes can be maintained.
Add in a few collisions, and you get Saturn's ravioli and croissant-shaped moons.
It's a bizarre process, but it leads to a beautiful form.
We know the moons affect the rings, but it looks like in this case, the rings affect the moons too. They're connected in both directions.
The rings form a moon factory, capable of building countless generations of new worlds.
This is a dance of physics.
If moonlets can form by these icy ring particles, they'll grow, and then their natural gravitational interaction with the rings will make them move out. They keep growing as they move out, but then another moon forms where the first one was. So you keep getting these growing moons, right? And this process repeats like on a conveyor belt. And what you wind up with is bigger moons orbiting farther out from Saturn and smaller ones orbiting closer in.